I'm Linda Black, the yoga coach. Today is just a lesson on Bhujangasana. So Bhujangasana translated means snake pose. And this is really like a snake. You know, if you've seen them lift their head, you want to think about one of those ancient snakes in the basket, really lifting up and creating a lengthening in the spine. Now, there's some common misalignments in Bhujangasana. So I'm going to take you through this step by step, A to Z, so you'll know the right way to do Bhujangasana so you can get the most benefit out of this beautiful heart opening posture. It's also the precursor to full upward facing dog or urdhva, muka, Svanasana. So to start with, you're going to want to lay on your belly. I'm going to show you the full pose and then we'll show some misalignments that and some corrections for them. Okay? Full pose. Hold for 3 or 4 breaths and then you come back down. It's a beautiful pose, yes? So, some common misalignments in Bhujangasana. One thing I often see is the hands placed too far forward, and then we push up and we're right into our low back. Keep the hands back, elbows hugging in, and shoulders at the height of the elbow. So your shoulder's gonna reach up, not down. Right here. See that? Yes. So hand placement first. And then when you lift, you're lifting with the muscles of the back, not necessarily pushing yourself up in a push-up. Okay, that's going to be a chaturanga. So we're not doing push-ups here. It's a back lift and a chest opener. The hands are here to support, not to hold. Okay, second misalignment that I often see is we get right in the low back and it's kind of achy. So here's what we're going to do about that. You're going to draw your waistline back. So watch. Waistline lifting up rather than a waistline releasing down, looks like this. So if I'm all relaxed in this area, I'm not protecting my low back. So my core actually has to be a little bit strengthened or engaged in order for this posture to work properly and just keep you out of your low back. So it looks like this from the ground. You're gonna have your feet really strong, tops of the feet down. And you're pressing into the floor till the knees lift. Got that? Then you're going to pull the waistline up just a little bit and you'll feel your tailbone tuck towards the back wall. Okay, so watch that again. This is a release and this is a drawing up. I'm scooping the pubic bone towards the floor and upward towards my navel. Or, in other words, the waistline draws away from the floor, even though it's still touching. Okay, hands positioned back here again, shoulder back. We talked about that. And then you're going to lift with the back, not press up with the hands. This is a lift, not a press. Hold for 3 or 4 breaths, Bhujangasana. It's a beautiful pose. It's also a great feeling when you get finished. Bhujangasana can help with depression and it can enliven your day and kind of give you a pick-me-up. Heart openers do that, so I really love that posture. It's a great way to, it's a good one in your sun salutations to really hone in and get familiar with and get very good at, because we do a lot of the low cobras and upward facing dogs or urdhva muka svanasana in a regular yoga sequence. So there you go, my A to Z for Bhujangasana. Take care and have a great day.